Τα ουίλι Πακιστάν, τα σπίς, κουλένα μπαμπαρί κουφτο σέβανε.
Τα ήτσι χαβαράνο το, τα τηλεπίπ χαβαράτο, Αμερικά, Πακιστάν, τα ουίλι και βάιεν, δε τα μίσα τίλ πατσάρτη, για τίλ πίπ τηλεφορε βιαί, ορυντά και μίσα πέρκουλ για τον Αμερικαβί, εντά φοβάλια Αμερικά και κύμα εδώ που Πακιστάν, τα ουίλι Πακιστάν και κύμ τα μίσα πούς μραβί, αρκο μίσα πάνε μπαμπαρί καβί, πατά και μίσα τα χαβαρά, να μάνει η Πακιστάν σαρά. Pakistan da zur bande ko pazur bande mija khalq manavi aur yai chida ga mija pip kham khal judavi
We have a Republican here tonight who's here to prove this is and should be a nonpartisan issue. I'd like to hear from Carl Schwartz, please. Carl.
What they found inside the FBI actually came from ongoing drug investigations dating back to 1998. And I heard the other day, just a minute ago, Mr. Thompson brought up Argentina, the company that had the contract with the Taliban is Brightus Corporation. They are from Argentina. On September 9, 2003, they won a lawsuit in our Fifth Circuit Court of Appeals. They had been tied up in the Texas courts since 1996. They won $500 million in a judgment for interference of contract in Turkmenistan. The only remaining thing was to take the Taliban and Brightus out. And then we control it all. We control the Caspian Basin oil. We have the pipeline to get it to the sea. The oil and gas in the Caspian Basin in current dollars is worth somewhere between $11 and $12 trillion. If you look at who was on the 9/11 Commission, on the Democrat side, who was directly benefiting, Mr. Ben Venice law firm was the law firm that kept Brightus tied up. They're also the law firm that lost the lawsuit when it went to the Supreme Court and the Fifth Circuit. They kept them tied up at least from 1998. They're involved in Pakistan, Turkmenistan, Kazakhstan, and Uzbekistan in about 20 different ways. You got the guy Thompson, the Republican governor, former governor of Illinois. He is sitting on the board of FMC. They have an oil and gas subsidiary. They make equipment. They're selling a lot of it overseas in the Caspian. Jamie Gorelick, I thought she was going to be a go-getter. I mean, I was rooting for her because she acted like she knew what she was doing. She sits on the board of Schlumberger, which is a competitor to Halliburton. Just within 2 weeks prior to the 9/11 Commission saying Sinai died and handing it over to the President and Congress to change our rights some more, which is what I think they plan to do, Schlumberger finally comes forward and admits they're having record profits in this last quarter, and they're doing a lot of big bucks business in the Caspian Basin. If you look at the reality that Brightus had a contract with the Taliban, we had landlocked oil and gas deals. We had to get it to the ocean. We had people actually doing business in Pakistan. You literally have to look at 9/11 and all of those foregoing issues as inseparable. There is your Pearl Harbor. I call them financial terrorists. I don't know what you would call them.
Were they members of or associated with the government?
Yes, well, one of them is a very key figure in security. He's a former military officer. He is someone that has had dealings with Jaish-e-Mohammed, one of the banned groups, with Maulana Azhar, who was in an Indian jail for decapitating three British tourists and three American tourists. And he also had dealings with Omar Sheikh, the man who murdered Osama bin Laden. Now, I know that having dealings with people does not necessarily mean direct evidence, but I also know that internal security has totally collapsed in Pakistan, and that internal security cannot collapse without there being some blind eye, if not collusion, being turned to the rise of the militants.